dairy.
Wow. Wow.
There's hardly any of us. Guess why?
Hard work.
Worse than hard work. How about hard work and it doesn't pay?
Yeah.
How long will anybody do that? It doesn't pay.
Wow.
There's 2,500 plus viable economic crops. If you're going to make it in it, you need to do something that's going to make money.
Yeah.
I would say probably forget about crops. I would say have a farm if you enjoy farming, because it's a wonderful thing to do. It's the best lifestyle in the whole world. Mm. Right? It'll keep you healthy. It'll keep your families together. It's not about money. If you start to differentiate yourself in life and money and family, and that's a big problem. You don't have time for all of it anyway. Exercise. This gives you exercise, family time, and some kind of a living, but it's not money living. Half of the money that people get goes to the government, who does not give us half of what we need. Okay? They don't. You need to find a way not to have economic income so you get more of that tax money back. That's more money in your pocket. But really, don't want so much stuff. People want too much stuff. Yeah. I'm just telling you. You're here to get my advice. Yeah. This is my advice. Yeah. Don't want so much stuff. What do you need? You need really good, healthy food. You need good neighbors. To be a good neighbor, you got to be a good neighbor. You got to be a good friend. You got to be. All that takes time. It's way better than having a boat and all kinds of other stuff. And I'm not judging anybody. I'm just telling you, this lifestyle means a totally different way of looking at your life. You will not make it. Mm-hmm. If dollar signs are in your mind looking out the field, you will not make it. Mm-hmm. Most people do not make it. I have trained hundreds of farmers. Almost nobody does. And I would not recommend it for people who are trying to make money at it. I do it because this is what I love to do. Mm-hmm. So that is the deal. It's first philosophical, spiritual. We need this is political. We have four sources of wealth. This is economics. Four sources of wealth in this world. We have the mines, the forest, the seas, and the farms. The mines, the forests, and the seas are basically controlled, and you don't have any, unless you're really rich, and I wouldn't expect you to be here, you don't have control of those three, but the farms are the last bastion of our economic wealth. And this is where we're going to make it. This is kind of, I don't like to use the term war, but this is our last bastion, right here. If we're going to be a free people, as Jefferson said, we've got to be on our land so that if a boss tells us to do something we don't want to do that's unethical, immoral, we can go home and we've got our food and we can do it. So we got to avoid high mortgages. People got to go back on the land, small plots. The zoning's got to change. And I think you should get out of agriculture and I think you should get into entertainment. People pay for entertainment. If you've ever watched the movie Food Inc., which you need to see, you will understand that food is kind of like a mafia business. It's very corrupt and controlled. You're not getting in. Do not think, oh, I've got a better way. I'll be smart. I'm going to go ahead and make something and get in. You won't get in. There's not enough market for you to get into. And they'll lock you out. You're not getting in.
That's where a lot of our tax dollars go.
I'm talking about coordinated, this is their term, coordinated production. But I'll tell you something else. Even though they've coordinated everybody, they are buying their own farms. Whole Foods, New Seasons. There's not a lot of markets for organic. People will not pay it. Okay? So you have the American taxpayer who comes and says, you need to pay minimum wage for your workers. You think you're going to pull in 500,000 pounds of vegetables out of here by yourself? You're not going to do it. You're going to have workers. And they're going to tell you, the American taxpayer is very, very generous with your time. And I'm not saying that we shouldn't pay a living wage. But they're very generous with your wages. Okay? But they're not generous with their money. They're generous with your money. So they say, this is how much people should have. You pay that. And then you pay that, and they won't buy the products that labor produces. They go buy it from slave labor in Mexico. So now, in addition to the fact that you're locked out of the market, you have no way of actually even competing against people who are paying the same for food as you do, but they get 20 times less money. The product is all labor. How are you going to come out? You got to do something really unusual, and I am never amazed at the creativity, ingenuity of American people. Tocqueville said this, and we are an amazing people. So go find something like a niche market or better entertainment. Our entertainment that we have is disgusting. It's not entertainment. It's disgusting. It destroys our soul, destroys our families, it destroys our children. So give people something wholesome. Very few people can walk on a farm, or especially an organic farm, and not smile. Sell them that. We need more entertainment. And the zoning has got to recognize that this is where people belong. Not clustered together in cities and pathological densities, watching people do things. They need to do things with their bodies. 2/3 of our population is overweight, 1/3 is obese. We are dying for too much food. So you really don't want to make more food. We have better food. You can be an educational teacher, a nutritional teacher. That's what I actually do. Okay? That's kind of what it's about. I probably have the largest, organic vegetable farms in the area. I would like to tell you it's profitable, it's not. So what we are doing is we're diversifying. I'm going to start a school, and I'm going to start educational, and then entertainment. And that's a really good thing. I'll give you an example. Over there is a place called the Pumpkin Patch on Savi's Island. They have 750,000 people show up to buy really crappy food. And it's in the corn maze. 750,000 people. They want the entertainment. They're willingly paying for it. That's a good thing. Mm-hmm. You are not going to make it in food. If you watch Food Inc., one thing you have to understand is they pay corn farmers more than the cost of production. A corn farmer sells corn for less than the cost of production. How can anybody make a living? He's subsidized by the government. Well, that subsidy goes for lower price of corn. Guess who comes in there and takes advantage of that? Our entire food system. They live as food whores off of corn, and they make everything out of corn. So now, who's paid for this corn?
We did.
You did.
Yeah.
Okay? You've paid for subsidized of corn. Now, what's healthier for a person? Lettuces, kales, or corn? Corn has almost no nutrition. Look it up. It's just starch. A little bit of protein. You know, it's just starch. It's not healthy food.
It's a chemical factory.
That's what they use. Not the corn plant. The corn plant is a wonder of nature. But it's a grass. It's cereal. Cereals have very, very little nutrition. What we should be eating is lean protein and lots of greens and vegetables. That's what we need to be eating. That's what we're meant to eat. And when we eat that way, we're very healthy. We don't need the medical system. I spent a lot of time teaching doctors at the farmer's market how to eat. Why? Because they sit in front of me fat. I said, you know why you're fat and you're weak? Because you don't know how to eat. And then they listen to me. Because they want to save their life and put 20 or 30 years on their life. There is no reason for people to age. None. People should hit 20 and stay at that health throughout their entire life except right before their death. And check it out. There are 90-year-olds, a lot of them. There's 70,000 100-year-olds. 70,000.
Wow.
There are 90-year-olds, many of them, who run marathons, lift weight. Look at Jack LaLanne. He works an hour a day. An hour a day on your health. You can do it. Okay? I can run here and there. You see that back to that fence? I can run there and back and I won't even be out of breath. I can do 3 sets of 65 push-ups. I am the same weight I was in high school. There is no reason why people have to age. Now, your arms and your face are going to age because they're exposed to the elements. But most of you, if you get down to weight and you look at your bodies, you look naked, you will look like you're 20. I'm not kidding. You get down to weight, your skin, even look at the upper arm, your skin here is not aged. You do not need to age. Your body will keep you very healthy if you eat the right food and you get exercise. Low stress, right food, exercise. This is genetic issues, but that's not most people. So we can have a better standard of living, but we need to get out there and we need to work harder. When they say we want more efficient lifestyles, wrong. We need less efficient lifestyles. We need people to work really, really hard. And one of the best things to do is to work hard at growing something. So this should be part of people's lifestyles. Okay? Not watching the tube, not sitting in a smelly gym, getting athlete's foot, doing no work. This is just not practical. This should be part of people's life. You know, like brushing their teeth, growing their food. They would have a connection to the soil. They'd be like way better voters. They would actually understand agricultural policy. It's really, really funny. In the beginning of the movie, Food Inc., that Michael Pollan, who wrote Alamos Vorsavella, says, I find it mind-boggling that I have to write a book and we have to have a movie telling people where their food comes from.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous. But that's where we are right now. And it's ridiculous. Now, there is a movement the other way. You people being here, the farmers market, lots of stuff is moving in the right direction. But still, there's lots of problems. So I would say look for ways to either write some kind of creative crop. There's those that are available. I personally have a hard time just creating some kind of crop for rich people. I don't think that's a big market, and I don't really want to be involved in that. I want to grow food for regular people. Ideally, the kinds of crops that I grow, farmers like me won't grow them anymore. People in the city should be growing their own until we can deconstruct the cities and make them much more livable with much more green space and space in between instead of people piled on top of people. What a stupid idea that was. Okay, where people can't even really grow their own food.
So that
they're a flat out slave and they're so worried about what happens if they lose their job. I post a job and I can't tell you how much it freaks me out to have so many people tell me I want the job because I'm going to lose my house, I'm going to lose this. There's no reason Americans should be to the point where we're running around afraid. You should have enough land around you to grow your own food. We should have building systems that are much cheaper. Pole barns like that, half that size, same square footage, $5,000 to $10,000 to build a thing. I mean, it's cheap. We should have no mortgages. We should have people on the land using it well. People with their families, not mommy, daddy, kids, everybody. It's like a weird life. We live this bizarro life. And then one problem goes on another problem. So we need to make organic agriculture work, because if we don't work, they're going to say, you see, it doesn't work. That's where we need all the petroleum, and we need the petrochemicals, and we need the wars, and we need the permanent war economy, and we need the industrial complex, and this complex, and that complex. So we have to win. You have to win. On every level. So that's what we're doing here.
Tell us about the entertainment farming. You would mirror some of the pumpkin patch stuff?
I would find anything. Look, I would, in a real world that's a respectful, loving world, you got three ways to get what you want. You got force, you got love, and trade. So get real good at those two, the love and the trade, and focus on your market. What do they want to pay for? Now, a lot of times they don't even know. Right? They're lacking something in their life, and you figure out, you love them enough to say, you know, this might help them. Come up with a new invention. Come up with something that's not being done well enough. It's not being done often enough. Somehow, be helpful. That's like the main thing. Try to be helpful.